Hey besties, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be doing a review on the comebacks in September. This one will be a bit shorter than the others I've done because there weren't that many I felt like reviewing. But please remember, this is just my opinion on the songs. Now, let's get started with the video. When I first heard she was getting a solo debut, I was so happy because even though I wish we got a Wacky Mookie comeback, at least we get something. And I feel like she has the most potential to be a good soloist anyways. The song is very chill but with bright vibes to it. It was kind of boring to me at first, but Girlie came through after the chorus and started giving more throughout the song. I feel like it's a lot of missed potential because this could have been released in the summer, but it's still a really nice song to listen to and shows off her talent. Although I can't really see myself playing this, I probably wouldn't skip it, so I'm gonna give it a 7.5 out of 10. When we pull up, you know it's a shutdown. 간판 내리고 문 잠가 shutdown. Whip it, whip it, whip it, whip it. Honestly, I still have mixed feelings about it. Like, I enjoy most of it, but there's parts that ruin the song for me. First, let's start with the music video. I think the homages to their past videos such as the Big Tank, Rose sitting on the globe and more were really clever and cute. And the outfits were so cute as well, like Lisa's black outfit was just too good. Now, for the song, here's some qualities I like about it. The production throughout the song seemed really clean. I mean, they're from a rich company, so makes sense, but I just like how clean and crispy everything is. Also, I think the classic violin instrumental was the highlight of the entire song for me. Like, it's very minimalistic but still so yummy to listen to. I don't know, it's just so pleasing to my ears. And I forgot to mention this, but I really like the choreography too. It's cute. However, the main gripes I have with this song is the ending of the song and the lack of a bridge. The song was so good until we got to the break. Jisoo and Rose already only really had lead-ins for the pre-chorus, so it would have been perfect to give them a good ass bridge that could transition into a nice ending, instead of just repeating the same few words and just ending. Like, Emma needs Eddie to take a masterclass on how to end a song properly because it's getting annoying. For the album, besides Pink Venom, the only song I would play on my own is Type of Girl. It's so good and fits them really well. Overall, I'm not too crazy about the title track, but it is objectively very good and catchy, and even though I prefer the album better than Bar and Pink, it's kind of good. So, I'm gonna give it another 7.5 out of 10. Not gonna lie, I was a bit nervous, especially since the teasers were giving very much Sticker 2.0, but I was very pleasantly surprised. I had listened to it a second time, because I was more focused on the music video, specifically Yuta, but listening to the song again and I love it. The lyrics in the chorus were a little corny, but it's SM Entertainment, so they always gotta put some weird ass lyrics. I personally think the rap verses and the bridge carry the song, like okay Jaehyun I see you, and the outro or ending to the song was too fucking good. It kind of reminded me of Cherry Bomb, so maybe that's why I like it so much. But regardless, it's so fun and catchy. We love that for real. Now on to the album. Dare I say, this is one of their best mini albums. There's a couple I like but don't care for, such as Black Clouds and 127, but the rest are so amazing. My favorite were Time Lapse, Designer, LOL, and Crash Landing. Also, can we talk about Time Lapse? Like, Dumb Joints is so fucking smart for making the beat ahead of the actual song in the chorus, because the song is called Time Lapse. A genius, actually. This album genuinely felt fun to listen to and was mostly enjoyable. Overall, this isn't my favorite title track by them, but it's really good and the album is even better, so I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. Well, this was a lot. I will say it was less messier than their debut. There are definitely some more good things I can say about this comeback compared to last time, such as the transitions were a bit cleaner, and even though the dance break was really abrupt, most of the switch-ups were pretty good, and the chorus was actually good, like not in a catchy way, but it actually sounds good and not unbearable. And the overall visuals and outfits look good. Now, Some of my main problems with the song is the excessive amount of talk rapping. Like, I don't mind some of it here and there, especially if it sounds fun or catchy, but there was way too much for no reason. And most of the girls in here can sing or at least hold a good note, so I don't understand why there's packed in talking rapping in there. And I do wish there could have been more of a build up in the last chorus to really pack a punch. Although I'm not too crazy about the song, I do like how fun it is and it does make you more interested in it. Also, their B-side Cool was really really good. It suits their singing too. I really love quirky concepts and having fun with different types of sounds and just overall experimenting. But you can still have an explosive song while still being clean and not too messy. I think they have the right idea, but just need a cleaner execution. But I do prefer this way more than OO, so I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. Welcome to the last word. 이제 멈출 수 없어. I'm really glad that we got a June solo early, especially since he's in a group with 12 other members and doesn't get that many lines in the first place, so it feels good to see him showing his talents more. I also think this type of concept fits him really well. The song starts off a bit slow, but I love the build-up and the intensity. It's not necessarily an amazing song that I would obsess over, but it is really good, so I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10. My beloved Zaiumin is finally back and might I say, he absolutely devoured. I don't know how to explain it, but his voice is just so EXO. Of course I know he's from EXO, but his voice just makes me miss those crispy EXO choruses where everyone is singing. And speaking of which, Weebin knew he has an amazing voice, but the song really highlights his beautiful and smooth vocals. Like seriously, thank you so much for not giving us a bland ballad. I love that hyped up talking verse in the beginning and in the post chorus. It reminds me of 2PM's song Hands Up, but it already gets you in the mood for the song. I don't know how to explain it, but it's just a vibey song. Like, it's very fresh and fun. And that bridge was too fucking good. I'm happy he got a concept and song that overall fits his voice and the vibe he exudes. I can definitely see myself listening to this song a lot. I'm gonna give it a 9.5 out of 10. What in the 4th gen Nugu girl group is this? Is this the same group that made I Love You, Lady, and Night Rather Than Day? I'm so confused. Don't get me wrong, I'm so happy the girlies are back, but at what cost? It's not a terrible song, but definitely their worst title track ever. At least the pre-chorus and ending of the song is really good, but the rest ain't it at all. Like, I never knew my girls were capable of making such a bland and not good song, but they did. And the music video, they must have had a budget of $10, because their company did them really dirty with these sets. At least they looked good though. I haven't listened to the B-sides yet, but hopefully it's better than this. I hope we can get another comeback to make up for this, because right now, I'm really not feeling it, so I'm gonna give it a 6.5 out of 10. And that's the end of the video. I hope you all enjoyed. Please like and subscribe if you'd want, and have a good day. Bye besties.